Living room is the heart of the home. Needless to say, it is a multifunctional space. A place to read, watch TV, entertain guests. Sometimes it turns to be the dining space, and sometimes I even treat the space to rejuvenate myself. I had to make it functional and visually appealing. Keeping in mind, this is the most trafficked area. These are the process that I went through while designing and decorating every space in this house. We will not take a deep dive into each of them in this video, but we will be tackling the last one. Do watch till end, as this content is loaded with tips and hacks to have a picture-perfect welcoming living room. This blank space went through 2D and 3D views. Needless to say, all done by myself. To get a visualization of the space as to how my imagination will look in real. And the journey from a clean slate to a well-executed wall of fame in the house was exciting. I don't prefer buying furnitures in set. When you use mixed furnitures, your eyes don't settle and it also breaks the symmetry of styling. At times it can be trickier, but it works. I have a 3-seater sofa, married with a recliner and 2 accent chairs. The TV unit has attached open bookshelves and a framed open shelving to hold my collectibles. As one of the focal points of this space, I worked on the cabinet top by adding a fabric, creating a layer. Use some books to elevate the accents. Started playing with the elements, creating different heights, layers and depth to it. Also, I have used odd number of accents to break the symmetry of the look. This is going to set the scene for the rest of the space entirely. This side is the most functional and has to be utilized keeping the gadgets and switches in mind. Just to break the blackest palette in the frame, I added some greens. And if you notice, this whole space has black metals and natural elements infused in it. Lastly, this has been the recent addition, keeping the current situation's demand. Coming to the next focal point of this room, the bookshelf. We read books, but we don't have too many of them and not too less to toss them in a closed space. It needed a proper address, and this is how this shelf came into life in this space. You can see I have arranged the books horizontally, vertically and as a backdrop. Basically, I tried playing with their arrangements and ended up adding objects. When books and objects are mixed, the shelf looks visually interesting. Probably I have used these open shelves to add colors in this blue dominated living room. I have a separate video on how you can use books to style your space. Do check that video after watching this. Here is the link of the playlist. If you want to know about the accessories used, do give me a follow on my Insta account, or you can subscribe and send your queries in the comment box. But please consider subscribing, as we creators go far to bring you valuable contents. It's totally free and, to be honest, acts as a booster to keep going. I love collecting accents. I find beauty in them. Before coming to this house, I had adored my rented home as if it was mine. Most of the accents were pre-existing, so this open self was a need. Your home should solve your purpose. Don't you agree? Well, I kept all these things in mind while designing this space. Some of the accents are gifted, some are collected, and some hold a very special place in my heart. Arranging selves is a design project in itself. A lot of things come into play. The right distance, the patterns, the color coordinates, and many more. Play around with the selves. Line up a few of the same objects for an interesting focal display. Or have a minimalist self in the mix with only one object on it. Or turn your books backward for a change to create a calming monochromatic effect. Maybe add a plant or something from the nature. And as always, make sure to use meaningful or natural objects that you love within your display. Well, presenting my curated collections on open selves adds that layered and sophisticated feel to my space and displays my touch that allows my guests to see the collections through my eyes. As a beginner, be a homeowner or a renter, this piece will help you to know what your style is. It's the most versatile piece. Including these can instantly change the look and are simple to swap objects that will uplift the look of the space. I guess one should start their decor journey by styling these side tables. And most importantly, don't forget to click a pic. When you will see the before and after pictures, you will be amazed to see how your styling sense has evolved. I always play around, and my Insta handle can inspire you to some extent. To begin with, try adding a focal point, add a box or books to elevate the accents, and some greenery. Sofa or beds, they are the foundation of the home. But I think the more you work around them, it brings all the fun and character to the space. To begin with, since it's all light colored sofa, I made sure to treat it with a throw. Tuck them tightly so that it doesn't go out of order even if used rigorously. Time to add cushions. In my recent community post, I got overwhelming answers from my viewers and thought to take it their way by adding less pillows. Styling with cushions is a whole lot chapter to deal, but for now, keep these things in mind. Never use same style cushion covers. Pick a busy pattern and a subtle pattern to create a difference, or a solid bold color with a flurry cushion are some of the options to try. This can create balance in your space without making it crowded. The best way to give your homes a fresh look in budget is to add textiles. My home is all set. The only way I can work around to break the boredom is add textiles. You can swap the pillows, or even just taking a throw that is lying in another room and styling it somewhere else allows you to see it differently. adding in here the two accent chairs to provide more room for seating. A tray on the coffee table to hold your regularly used stuffs can actually keep your space organized and easy to move when not in use. I made this room feel incredibly welcoming with all furnitures wrapped together in a color scheme where I followed 60:30:10 rule. 60% of the room was dominated by blue, 30% is accentuated with yellow, and 10% of the room has used pops of colors to balance out the look. The carpets, the curtains were chosen carefully to blend in with the look of the space. A balanced room that doesn't seem heavier on eyes is art, and to some extent I have achieved it. What's your take on this room? Do let me know in my comment box. When I see my work, I feel positive, and bringing it in the notice of my viewers is equally exciting. It's not easy to play with colors, it may go wrong too, but the process of learning what works, what not, is a journey in itself. I have a playlist on my home related topics where I have shared my foyer, my bedrooms, etc. Do check that out, leave your queries, your reactions on my comment box, cause you will find me there more. I hope you like this content. Signing off for today. Meet you all soon. Much love. Bye-bye.